You can share your Google Calendar with those both inside and outside your organization. To see what options you have for sharing your calendar, hover your mouse over your calendar under My Calendars and click the down arrow. Then select Share This Calendar. It's here that you can view and adjust the sharing settings for your calendar, as well as share your calendar with individuals. Sharing is enabled by selecting the Share This Calendar with Others checkbox. Most likely, this option is already enabled for you. Then, there are two settings for sharing a calendar. Make this calendar public, which allows people outside your organization to see your calendar, and share this calendar within your organization. The amount of control you have over these settings is set by your Google Apps administrator. In this example, if you select Make this calendar public, you'll only have the option to allow others outside your organization to see when you're free or busy. So someone outside your organization would see your calendar like this. They can see your events, but there are no titles or details included. There are other options for calendar visibility outside your organization, but they're usually set by your Google Apps administrator. The second option here allows you to control how much of your calendar information coworkers can see. So you can choose to allow coworkers to see all your event details or see just when you're free or busy. Another way to share your calendar is with specific people or groups. Start by adding the email address of the person you want to give access to your calendar, and press Enter on your keyboard or click the Add Person button. In this example, I'll share my calendar with Ellie from HR. Now you can adjust the permission settings you want to give the person. There are generally four options available when sharing a calendar. If you're sharing with someone inside your organization, you can allow them to see just your free and busy time, see all your event details, which include the title of events and the description, and even allow others to make changes to your calendar. So if I set the permission settings for Ellie to make changes to events, she can edit and add events to my calendar. Also, my calendar will appear in her list of other calendars, like this. And if I set Ellie's permission settings to make changes and manage sharing, this allows her to edit my calendar and even allow other people to access my calendar. This also moves my calendar into Ellie's My Calendar section. Obviously, you want to take care when giving people permission to edit and share your calendar, but this can be a great way for teams to share the work of managing a calendar. You see, these sharing options are not only available in your personal calendar, but to any calendar you create. So, if you want, you could create a team calendar that tracks events or time off just by giving everyone access to the calendar. In fact, there's an easy way to do this. If your group already has a group email address, you can set permissions for an entire group. At Cloud Easel, there's an HR group, so if I type in the HR group's email address, I can share this calendar with everyone in that group and set the permissions for the group. So there are some ways to share calendars with internal groups. What about people outside your organization? If a person is outside your organization, Calendar will only allow you to share your calendar according to the settings for public calendars. So if I share my calendar with a friend, the only permission settings I can set are those that are allowed by my domain. Hopefully you can see how powerful yet simple it is to share your Google Calendar. If you have questions about sharing your Google Calendar, click Settings, then Help for more information.